pray.
Our
Father in heaven, we bless your name for this opportunity once again to gather in your presence.
We
thank you for this special meeting and how you have made it possible. People all over the world are running up and down after so many things, but you have given us the love for your word to come together, come apart, so that we can be refreshed and renewed again.
Praying
that your purpose for bringing us into this place of meeting today will be achieved in all our lives in Jesus' name.
Every
one of us has fallen asleep, and where it appears asleep, we are no more sensitive to the Spirit of God and to the things of heaven, waking us up in Jesus' name. We are praying, Father.
Baba,
whatever you will need to do,
that
will be alive in the Lord,
alive
in the Spirit,
alive
in Christ. You will do it in us in Jesus' name. Anoint your words in our heart with desired impact in our lives in Jesus' name.
Because
you know you have answered. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
In Psalm 13 and the third verse. Consider and hear me, O Lord my God. Lighten my eyes, lest I sleep the sleep of death. And the message you are considering at this time is the sleep of death. To surprise you, sleep is a wonderful gift from God, given by God after a hard day's work for man to relax himself, refresh himself, liven up his body. In fact, the Bible tells us that it is the one God loves, it is the one God delights in, that he gives sleep to.
Psalm 127 and the 2nd verse.
It is vain for you to rise up early, to sit up late, to eat the bread of sorrows. Now listen to this. For so he giveth his beloved
sleep.
When God, you know, looks at you and he favors you and he gives you the ability to sleep in the night, it's a gift of God. But now we're talking about a different kind of sleep. Although sleep is a gift from God, it's done in a wrong way, done at a wrong time, done at a wrong place. When sleep results in the loss of spiritual virtue, when sleep results in the loss of spiritual life, at that point it becomes the sleep of death. In 1 Samuel chapter 26, look with me in verse 5. Remember, Saul had been looking for David. A time came when David met Saul sleeping somewhere. And you know what happened at that time? We surprised you that it could happen to a soldier like Saul, a king like Saul. In verse 5, and David arose and came to the place where Saul had pitched. And David beheld the place where Saul lay, and Abner the son of Ner, the captain of his host, and Saul lay in the trench, and the people pitched round about him.
David is in the day, O sì wá sí ibi tí Sọ́ọ̀lù pàgọ́ sí. Dávid sì rí ibi tí Sọ́ọ̀lù gbé dùbúlẹ̀ sí, àti Abneri ọmọ Neri olórí ogun rẹ̀. Sọ́ọ̀lù sì dùbúlẹ̀ láàrin àwọn kẹ̀kẹ́, àwọn ènìyàn náà sì pàgọ́ wọn yìí ká.
Verse 7.
Ẹsẹ̀ keje.
So David and Abishai came to the people by night, and lo, Saul lay sleeping within the trench, and his spear stuck in the ground at his bolster, but Abner and the people lay round about him.
Bẹ́ẹ̀ni Dávid àti Abishai sì tọ àwọn ènìyàn náà wá ní òru sí wo. Sọ́ọ̀lù dùbúlẹ̀ tí ó sì ń sùn láàrin kẹ̀kẹ́, a sì fi ọkọ rẹ̀ gúnlẹ̀ níbi tìmùtìmù rẹ̀. Abneri àti àwọn ènìyàn náà wọ́n sì dùbúlẹ̀ yìí kan.
Then said Abishai to David, God hath delivered thine enemy into thy hand this day. Now therefore, let me smite him, I pray thee, with a spear, even to the ground at once, and I will not smite him the second time.
Ẹsẹ̀ kẹjọ. Abishai sì fún Dávidì pé Ọlọ́run ti fi ọ̀tá rẹ̀ lé ọ lọ́wọ́ lónìí. Ǹjẹ́ èmi bí ọ̀ sájà jẹ́ kí èmi kí ó fi ọkọ̀ gún un mọ́lẹ̀ lẹ́ẹ̀kan, èmi kì yóò gún un lẹ́ẹ̀mọ́lẹ̀ kejì.
Look at this scene here.
Wo tó ṣẹlẹ̀ níbí yìí.
Saul was looking for David to kill.
Sọ́ọ̀lù ló wá èmi Dávidì láti parun.
And now Saul was sleeping.
Báyìí Sọ́ọ̀lù wá ń sùn.
And the sleep was so deep so much that when David and Abishai were discussing, they were talking, this man did not wake up.
Oòrùn tí Sọ́ọ̀lù sùn yìí ó jinlẹ̀ lọ́pọ̀lọpọ̀ tó bẹ̀ nígbà tí David àti Abishai ló jọ sọ̀rọ̀ papọ̀. Àdìpé Sọ́ọ̀lù tají.
All the soldiers, they were sleeping equally.
Gbogbo àwọn jagunjagun Sọ́ọ̀lù náà ló ń sùn lẹ́ẹ̀kan náà.
The discussion between David and Abishai was going on, they didn't wake up.
Ìtàkùrọ̀sọ láàrin Dávid àti Abishai ó ń lọ ohun ọ̀sì jí.
Abishai said, let me kill this man.
Abishai wí fún Dávid pé jẹ́ kí n pa ọkùnrin
yìí. Anything David wanted to do with Saul at that time, he could do it because the man was asleep.
Ohun kan tí Dávid fẹ́ ṣe sí Saul ní ìgbà yẹn ló lè ṣe, torí pé Saul ti sùn fọ́fọ́.
Think about that and bring it to the spiritual life.
Ronú nípa ìyẹn bẹ́ẹ̀ ká wá mu wá sí ìgbésí ayé ti ẹ̀mí.
The kind of sleep you sleep spiritually.
Irú oru ẹ̀mí tó ń sùn.
That the devil come.
Tí èṣù á sì wá.
How the demons come.
Àwọn ẹ̀mí èṣù á wá.
They are planning and plotting to take away your life spiritually. Life and even your physical life, and here you're sleeping.
Wọ́n sì ń bímọ papọ̀ láti fagilé ìgbésí ayé ẹ̀mí rẹ̀ àti ìgbésí ayé rẹ̀ gan nípa ti ara ìwọ ni ó sì ń sùn síbẹ̀.
And although David did not kill Saul.
Mo ti ẹgbẹ́ Dávidì ò pa Sọ́ọ̀lù.
Look at verse 12.
Wo ẹsẹ̀ kejìlá.
So David took the spear and the cruse of water from Saul's bolster, and he brought them away. No man saw it, nor knew it, neither awake, for they were all asleep, because a deep sleep from the Lord was falling upon them.
Ẹsẹ̀ kejìlá. Dávid sì mú ọkọ̀ náà àti ìgò omi náà kúrò ní ibi tìmùtìmù Sọ́ọ̀lù. Wọ́n sì bá tí wọ́n lọ. Kò sì sí ẹnìkan tí ó rí tàbí tí ó mọ̀. Kò sì sí ẹnìkan tí ó jí. Gbogbo wọn sì sùn nítorí pé ohun ìjìkà láti ọ̀dọ̀ Olúwa wá ó ti ṣubú lù
wọ́n. I will not sleep the sleep of death.
Gbogbo àdá pé òní sun orun ikú.
David took the spear Saul away.
Dávid mú ọkọ̀ sáré dáre Sọ́ọ̀lù lọ.
His instrument to defend himself.
Òun náà tó jẹ́ ìlà tó fi ìyà tó fi ń dáàbò bo ara rẹ̀.
What he needed to protect himself.
Òun tó ní láti fi dáàbò bo ara rẹ̀.
And what he needed to even fight against his enemy.
Ohun ìjà pápá láti bá ọ̀tá rẹ̀ jà ní.
That was taken away from him.
Àmùkú ọ̀lọ́dọ̀ Sọ́ọ̀lù.
Not only that, the water that will sustain his life.
Yẹ́nì kan kó omi náà fẹ́ kó mu fún àmì ara rẹ̀.
In the hot sunny desert.
Ní ìgbà tó yẹ pé òòrùn mú ní pápá níbi tó wà lọ́wọ́.
And he needed water to refresh himself.
Ó nílò omi yẹn láti tu ara rẹ̀ lára.
The enemy came and took everything away.
Ó rí bẹ́ẹ̀ yọ̀tá wá ó sì kó gbogbo rẹ̀ lọ.
Completely naked.
Ó rí pé Sọ́ọ̀lù báwo di ẹni o.
What happens to us in our life?
Ohun tó ń ṣẹlẹ̀ tí wọ́n máa yé wa nìyẹn.
The sleep of death.
Nígbà tó bá sọ orin ikú.
The sleep that the devil enables the devil to steal away all the virtues, all the grace, all the righteousness, all the power, all the anointing. He takes everything away from our lives.
Nígbà tó bá sùn lọ́pọ̀lọpọ̀ tó bẹ́ẹ̀ gẹ́gẹ́ pé ó wá gba sàdáyì láàyè láti ń gbogbo ọ̀ṣọ́ kìrìsìtẹ́nì ayé rẹ̀, gbogbo agbára ọlọ́run tó wà ní ayé rẹ̀, gbogbo orí ọ̀fẹ́ tó wà ní ayé rẹ̀, ìmí tó wà ní ayé rẹ̀, a sì jí wọn lọ.
Sleep of death.
Ó yẹ orin ikú.
In Judges chapter 16.
Àwọn onídàájọ́ orí kẹrìndínlógún.
And verse 19.
Ẹsẹ̀ ìkọkàndínlógún.
Judges chapter 16 verse 19.
Onídàájọ́ orí kẹrìndínlógún ẹsẹ̀ ìkọkàndínlógún.
And she made him sleep upon her knees, and she called for a man, and she caused him to shave off the 7 locks of his head, and she began to afflict him, and his strength went from him.
Ó sì mú kí ó sùn ní eegun rẹ̀. Ó sì pe ọkùnrin kan. Ó sì mú kí a bá ìdí inú oru méjèèjì orí rẹ̀. Ó sì bẹ̀rẹ̀ sí pọ́n lójú. Agbára ìrẹ̀lẹ̀ sì ti lọ kúrò lọ́dọ̀ rẹ̀.
And she said, the Philistines be upon thee, Samson. And he woke out of his sleep and said, I will go out as at other times before and shake myself. And he wist not that the Lord was departed from him.
Ó sì wí pé àwọn Philistines dé Samson ní. Ó sì jí kúrò ní ojú oorun rẹ̀. Ó sì wí pé èmi ò jáde lọ bí ti ìgbà. tẹ̀sájú kí èmi kí ó sì gbọ́n ara mi òun kò sì mọ̀ pé olúwa ti kú lọ́dọ̀ òun.
Here is a sleep of death.
Omi kúlẹ̀ ni yìí sùn
mí. Before Samson let that sleep, the power of God was with him.
Kí Samson lè kó tó so orin ikú ìyàgbọ́ Ọlọ́run ti wà nínú ayé rẹ̀.
By the time he woke up from that sleep, the power of God had departed from him.
Ìgbà tó fi máa tají lójú okú ọ̀nà orí jọ orin ikú yẹn agbọ́n Ọlọ́run ti fi sílẹ̀.
What do we then see from that?
Kí la wá kẹ́kọ̀ọ́ mbẹ́ yẹn?
You sleep.
Inú ohun tó bá ń sùn.
Whether physical
or
spiritual.
Àwọn ohun tẹ̀mí.
That takes away the power of God from your life.
Ohun yàgbọ́ Ọlọ́run kókó inú ayé rẹ̀.
The grace of God.
Kí orí ọ̀fẹ́ Ọlọ́run kó kúrò.
The presence of God.
Ìwàláyé Ọlọ́run tó kúrò.
You sleep and then you wake up and all those things are gone from your life. That is the sleep of death.
Nígbà tó o sùn tó wá tayé tí gbogbo orí ọ̀fẹ́ wọ̀nyí agbára ọ̀rọ̀ tó kó inú ayé rẹ̀ o ti sọnu ikú.
You may be alive physically but spiritual life gone. Look at Samson here.
Wo Samson ni bi?
The woman made him to sleep.
Obìnrin yẹ o mú kó sùn.
Bana ni.
Lórí egbò itan rẹ̀.
And they were removing the hair of his head.
Wọ́n ti yọ inú orí Samson ni.
Actually, the Philistines had been looking for the life of Samson for a long time.
Bàbá wo sùn náà, àwọn ará Philistines ti wá ìgbésí ayé ń wá ìmí Samson ni fún ọ̀pọ̀lọpọ̀ ìgbà.
He was the tormentor in chief of the Philistine army.
Samson náà ni ẹni náà fẹ́ pé nínú oyin tó ń fi ojú orin náà wọ jagunjagun Philistine dán ni.
And he had been looking for the secret of his power.
Wọ́n ti wá àṣírí agbára Samson ni.
No, Simon, Satan had desired to have you that he may sift you like me.
Wọ́n ti gbàgbé ọ̀rọ̀ Jésù pé Simoni kíyèsí. Sábà nífẹ̀ẹ́ láti ní ọkọ lè pọ̀ bí àlìkámọ̀.
A believer, you ought to remember the devil is looking for the secret of your power.
Ó bá jó nígbàgbọ́, ó yẹ kó o lọ́ sí pé èṣù wà síra agbára ayé rẹ.
So as a Christian worker is looking for the secret of your anointing, your usefulness in the hand of God.
Pàápàá yóò gẹ́gbọ́ iṣẹ́ Kìrìsìtẹ́nì, ó ń wá àṣírí ìbànúwọ́rọ̀-yàn rẹ àti ìwúlò ẹ̀ lọ́wọ́ Ọlọ́run.
The devil is looking for that thing that God saw in you and he chose you for his own servant.
Sátani ó wo èṣù ń wá òun náà tọ́lọ́run nínú ayé rẹ tó mú kó kó bí yàn gẹ́gẹ́ bí ìránṣẹ́ rẹ̀.
He wants to take that thing away from you.
Ó fẹ́ mú ọ̀ṣọ́ ẹbí ẹ̀ náà kó nu ayé rẹ.
You become useless.
Ó
bá lè jẹ́ láì
wúlò.
Lose your place in the program of God.
Ìpàlẹ̀ pàdánù ipò rẹ̀ nínú ètò Ọlọ́run.
And Samson was playing with that woman.
Orí Samson òun bó obìnrin yẹn ṣeré.
Eventually he told the woman the secret.
Nígbà ó ṣe ó sọ àṣírí agbára rẹ̀ fún obìnrin náà.
And the woman knew that I couldn't take this thing from this man when he's away.
Obìnrin náà sì mọ̀ pé mi ò lè mú nǹkan yìí kúrò lọ́wọ́ Samson nígbà tó bá sì tají.
And he made him to sleep.
Ó wá mú kó sùn.
A costly sleep.
Oorun tó náni ní gan.
A dangerous sleep.
Oorun tó léwu.
An evil sleep.
Oorun búburú.
And then when she is slept.
Nígbà tó sùn.
They were shaving off the hair of his head.
Wọ́n fa orí rẹ̀.
I mean, what kind of sleep is that?
Irú oorun wo nìyẹn?
In those days, they didn't have the modern clipper like we have today.
Ní ayé ìwé ìgbà wọn ni wọ́n ní ìkọ́tọ̀ fi ẹlẹ́nu bí eléta ní lóde òní.
That today you can be doing it and somebody may not know you are doing anything. They will hold the air, will take knife and begin to cut off the thing.
Nígbà tí Jẹ́rì wá di irun yẹn wún ni ẹnìkan ó sì mú ọ̀bẹ yóò máa gé.
This man was so asleep that they were cutting off all the hair, shaking all the head and everything and he did not wake up.
Orin yé oorun rẹ̀ wọ́n dùn mọ́ lọ́pọ̀lọpọ̀. Wọ́n fa inú orí rẹ̀, wọ́n gé ní ìsàn kò dẹ̀ jí náà.
Sleep up there.
Irun oorun ikú.
By the time he woke up.
Ìgbà tó ń máa jí.
All the secret of the grace of God in his life.
Gbogbo àṣírí orí ọ̀fẹ́ Ọlọ́run nínú ayé rẹ̀.
The power of God in his life.
Agbára Ọlọ́run nínú ayé rẹ̀.
The mercy of God in his life.
Ìbànú Ọlọ́run nínú ayé rẹ̀.
Everything had been taken away from him.
Gbogbo ẹ̀ láti gbúgbò lọ́dọ̀ rẹ̀.
That is the sleep of death.
Eléyìí gan là ń pè ní orun ikú.
As a Christian worker, you need to check your life.
Ẹ̀rọ ìṣe Kìrìsìtẹ́nì ó yẹ kó wo ayé rẹ̀.
Are you spiritually alive?
Ṣé o wà láyé nípa tẹ̀mí?
Spiritually away.
Ṣé o jí nípa tẹ̀mí?
You are so asleep that the devil will steal every grace, everything away from you.
Àbí o ti sun oorun àṣùjù náà tó bẹ́ẹ̀ jẹ́ gbẹ́gbẹ́ ìṣòro fi jí ogun tó wà nínú ayé rẹ̀ kúrò.
Hey, if you are that asleep, God will wake you up today in Jesus' name.
Ìgbàdàn sọ pé wọn ló ti sunrú oorun bẹ́ẹ̀. Ọlọ́run yóò jí Ọlọ́run lórúkọ
Jésù. The point in this message.
Àwọn òkúkọ mẹ́ta ní ìwàásù yìí.
Number one.
Àkọ́kọ́.
A costly sleep of careless saints.
Oorun tó ń náni ní nǹkan láti pàdánù nǹkan tó jẹ́ ti onígbàgbọ́ aláfara.
A costly sleep of careless saints.
Oorun tó ń sọ ló mú kẹ̀kọ́ pàdánù nǹkan fún onígbàgbọ́ tó jẹ́ aláfara.
Point number two.
Kókó kejì.
The cunning strategy of cruel Satan.
Ọgbọ́n yìí ni ike ti Sátani ti ṣe ni búburú.
The cunning strategy of Satan. Cruel Satan.
Ọgbọ́n yìí ni ike ti Sátani tó jẹ́ ni búburú.
Point number three.
Kókó kẹta.
The counsel of scripture to Christ's servant.
Ìmọ̀ràn ìbíbélì fún ìránṣẹ́ Kristi.
The counsel of the word of God to the servants of Christ.
Ìmọ̀ràn Ọlọ́run fún àwọn ìránṣẹ́ Kristi.
Let's go back to point number one.
Ẹ ká lọ sí kókó àkọ́kọ́.
Costly sleep of careless saints.
Oorun tó ń náni ní
Now when we talk about sleep here, yeah, it's not talking only about you get on your bed, you close your eyes. Let's start from that one you know. Physical sleep is good. But if you carry it too far, it can lead to spiritual sleep. There are other things that lead to spiritual sleep. Let me say, there are other things that lead to the sleep of death. One of those things is physical sleep that is taken too far. And this sleep of death is dangerous. What does it mean, sleep of death? Proverbs chapter 6. Proverbs chapter 6 and verse 9. Here it tells us about a man that slept. Proverbs chapter 6, verse 6. Go to the ant that sluggard, consider ways and be wise. Having no guide, overseer, or ruler, provided her meat in the summer and gathers her food in the harvest. Long will thou sleep, O sluggard? When will thou arise out of thy sleep? Yet a little slumber, a little folding of the hands to sleep, so shall thy poverty come as one that traveleth, and thy want as an armed man. The picture here is a picture of an individual that is sleeping. He ought to be praying, but he is sleeping. To be reading the word of God, but he's sleeping. To be engaging in the spiritual disciplines, but he's sleeping. We are told that man, poverty will come upon him because of too much sleep. You're a believer and you are just a sleeper. It brings spiritual poverty. Because when you are sleeping, you will not pray. In the morning you sleep. In the afternoon you sleep. In the night you sleep. When you kneel down, you sleep. You stand up, you sleep. Every time, even under the message of the word of God, you sleep. Bring you to spiritual poverty. The Bible says, not sleep lest thou come to poverty. The poverty will come as one that travels. That means this man was going on a journey. And he had some food with him. He had some materials with him. But he did not make arrangement for replenishment along the journey. So, somewhere in the journey, all the material resources got finished. There is poverty. Sometimes in the big cities, you find somebody will come to you sometimes. Well-dressed young man. I was coming from Lagos. I am coming from Kano. I came to Ibadan here. I didn't meet my uncle. I was going up and down, my money finished. You give me anything you can get there. Poverty come as one that travels. The journey to heaven is so far. Traveling from earth to heaven. Unless we make arrangement for replenishing grace in our lives, poverty will come. And you know, when we are not doing spiritual duties, we become poor. Sleeping. You ought to be reading the Bible. You are dozing. When you are listening to the word of God, you are sleeping. That your lead, that's a costly sleep. Lead to the sleep of death. Not only that. Proverbs chapter 24. And verse 30. Proverbs chapter 24. And verse 30. I went by the field of the slothful, and by the vineyard of the man void of understanding. And lo, it was all grown over with thorns, and nettles that covered the face thereof, and the stone wall thereof was broken down. When I saw and I considered it well, I looked upon it and I received instruction. Yet a little slumber, a little folding of the arms to sleep, so shall thy poverty come as one that traveleth, and I want as an armed man. An individual who had a field. Weeds were growing in that field, he didn't pay attention. Thorns and nestles were growing in that field, the man did not pay attention. He was busy sleeping when he should be weeding all the bad things from his own farm. And that sleep leads him to the sleep of death. The believer today, the Christian life is likened to a vineyard. Your life is like a vineyard. If you don't take the time, see that regularly you are weeding all the bad things, all the things the enemy tries to put upon your life, weeding them all. You see that talkativeness is coming in. Are you going to weed it out when you are sleeping? You see that prayerlessness is coming in. You see that carelessness is coming in. You see that unclean thoughts are coming in. You see that lack of passion for souls is coming in. You see that you are losing appetite for the word of God. You are no longer interested in serving God and in, you know, evangelism. Spiritual duties are becoming a burden to you. You see that you don't have appetite even for preaching the word of God again. You see that other things are engaging your attention. You don't have the time to weed all those things out of your life. Sleeping. That can lead to the sleep of death. And you know, the devil is very wicked. Keep you sleeping like that because he knows the longer you sleep, the easier for him to destroy you. In Proverbs chapter 19 verse 15. Fullness casteth into a deep sleep, and an idle soul shall suffer hunger. God is telling you that many workers' lives today, the slothfulness has put them in the sleep of death. You used to pray before. You have abandoned that now. That is a state of the sleep of death. And the devil is preparing you eventually for spiritual death. When you wake up, danger lies at your door. Does it mean sleep of death? Yeah, it means all that I told you about. It means some other things.
chapter 10.
No, Morike wa.
That's fine.
Ese kanu.
Proverbs chapter 10.
Morike wa.
That's fine.
Ese kanu.
He that gathers his summer is a wise son, but he that sleepeth in harvest is a son that causes shame.
Eni to ba ko jo ni igberun ni ologun omo. Sugbon to ba sun ni igbekore, omo tin loju tin ni.
Son that sleeps in harvest.
Omo to sun ni igbekore.
From there.
O je orun iku.
The time for harvesting souls into the kingdom.
Ogo ni lati je lo lati ko ro ti jo bo run.
He preaching the word.
Others
are busy giving their best to the Lord. Busy praying for souls. Are busy fasting for souls. You are not involved in all that.
Because
you are part of it before you slept the sleep of death. Before that, before now, you also are front line in that business. Now you are sleeping in the time of
harvest.
All the passion gone. All the zeal gone. All the prayerfulness gone. All the sensitiveness of the Holy Ghost gone. It means you become insensitive to the Spirit of God. It means spiritual dullness. Isaiah chapter
29
and verse 10. Isaiah chapter
29
verse 10. The Lord has poured out upon you the spirit of deep sleep and has closed your eyes. The prophets and the rulers, the seers, has he covered.
He's
telling us that spiritual sleep is also possible in spiritual leaders. When people are no longer close to the Lord, God allows the devil to give them a sleep of death. He allows the enemy to give them that deadly sleep. Eyes are closed, they cannot see danger anymore. Sleeping the sleep of death. Eyes are closed. Your sensitiveness to the devil, it becomes dark. Sensations come in very easily. Sliding very easy at that time. The ability to resist evil becomes
weakened.
Isaiah chapter 56. I'm reading there in verse 10. His watchmen are blind. They are all grown. They are all ignorant. They are all dumb dogs. They cannot bark. Sleeping, lying down, loving to slumber. You and me, Christian workers, spiritual leaders. In verse 9, he had called the beasts of the field to come and devour. Come and eat. Come for a feast. Demons of hell. Powers of darkness. All the agents of Satan. This church. Telling them, he said, they come into that floor. Because he said they could eat anything they
wanted.
The reason was because the watchmen that should be watching over those people, they are blind. Spiritual leaders are sleeping, the devil goes and goes to work and he does it at his own will. They are all ignorant. They are dumb dogs. Sleeping, lying down, loving to slumber. Because of their sleep, a lot of things are destroyed. Brothers and sisters, examine your life. Or are you in the condition of sleep up there? The devil rocks you to sleep. And you are no longer sensitive to the things of heaven. Your ears are growing here and there, and you are not aware of it. The time you are sleeping the sleep of death, quiet time is taken away from you.
on Bible, but it's like you are that blind, you cannot see anything. Yes, you know that this is sin, but you are beginning to resist
rebuke.
And then your hatred for sin becomes blessing.
That's
what the devil does.
The
sleep of death. And it comes when we are careless in our spiritual life. It can cause us a lot of things here on earth. It can cause a lot of destruction in the church. It can even cause us eternity at last. We go to point number two. This sleep of death we are talking about is the cunning strategy of the devil. Those people, the devil gets you to sleep. Well, the secret we can learn it from the life of Samson. Why did the devil cause Samson to sleep? Because the devil knew that if Samson was awake, he couldn't do whatever he wanted with Samson. You dare not come near a wakeful Samson. You dare not do any nonsense near a wakeful Samson. If you can call that Samson to sleep. Cause that worker to sleep. And cause that prayer warrior to sleep. Cause that preacher to sleep. And cause that chorister to sleep. And cause those believers to sleep. But if you can cause that church to sleep, and then the devil can go ahead and do whatever he
likes.
Judges chapter 16, verse 19. Judges chapter 16, and she made him sleep upon her knee. She made him sleep. When the devil is about to strike you, a mortal, a destructive blow, a blow you can never recover from, what does he do? He first of all rocks you to sleep. Delilah wanted to remove the power of God from the life of Samson. He wanted to remove the locks of her hair, of his hair. She caused him to sleep. Be careful of those things that rob you of spiritual sensitiveness. Where are those things that dull your spiritual senses? Beware of those things that make you to be insensitive to the voice of the Spirit of God. Even beware of too much physical sleep. Sleep that will not allow you to pray. Not allow you to do night vigil if there's any
need.
Sleep that whenever you have slept, you are kneeling down to pray, then you are sleeping again. Sleep, sleep all the while. The devil rocks that man to sleep.
Before
the man woke up, he had taken away every virtue, every grace, every power, every anointing away from his life. Devil is busy in the world today. Rocking many Christians to sleep. Things they would not permit in their lives before. Time of sleep, they bring it upon them. The things they would be sensitive to before. When they are sleeping, they will not make them to see it anymore. Consecration they made before. Life is for Jesus. I will never go back. Everything belongs to the Lord. God is my Lord. I will never go this way. I will never go that way. This narrow way to heaven. Spiritual sleep, the sleep of death, those things have been permitted in their lives already. Chances we didn't take before, now we are taking them. The sleep of death is coming in. The language that will not come out of your mouth, come out of
of your mind because the sleep of death has come in. The friendships you will never permit in your life. When you permit them in your life, when you are sleeping, the sleep of death. You find that the thing that you consecrated to the Lord,
why you
put them into this church?
I'm
going to serve you. I will live for you. I will follow you. Life or in death, I will be for the Lord. Don't you see now when we are sleeping the sleep of death, all those things are sapped away by the devil. Shock you.
The
things that believers permit in their lives today.
People who say,
I will die for the Lord. I will live for the Lord. I will follow the Lord. Because now they are sleeping, they sleep
today.
The devil has sown some evil seeds in their lives.
You say,
my brother and sister,
it's
meant to wake you
up.
And if you hear this kind of message that you are still sleeping, God's hope is there for you. Matthew chapter 13 and verse 24, another parable put it forth unto them, saying, the kingdom of heaven is likened unto a man which sowed good seed in his field. But wild men slept. His enemy came and sowed tares among the weeds and went his way. How did that the strategy of the devil? When you are awake, he doesn't come near you. When you are alive, he doesn't come near you. When you are fire, he doesn't come near you. Secures your sleep. He gets you to sleep. And then those things that shocked you before, they will shock you again. The things that you hated before, suddenly they become harmless now. But no, that is the sleep of death. The enemy came and sowed bad seed among the good seed. Look at your life. Do you see any bad seed coming up? Do you see anger coming up? Do you see lying coming up?
Do
you see hatred coming
up?
Do you see hypocrisy coming
up?
Do you see pride coming
up?
You see that the devil will bring all those things so that he will draw you to sleep and take away all the blessing of God from your life. The enemy will come. You know, Satan will rob you of all the virtues. When it comes to afflict you, with temptation, with sin, your defenses will be weak. That's what he did. Peter and the disciples. Matthew chapter
26.
And in verse 38. Matthew 26, verse
38.
Said he unto them, my soul is exceeding sorrowful, even unto death. Tarry ye here and watch with me. Tarry ye here and watch with me. That was Jesus telling the disciples to join him in prayer. But verse 40,
he
cometh unto the disciples and he findeth them asleep. Sleep is a state of unconsciousness. Temporary unconsciousness. You know what is happening all around you? And the disciples were sleeping at this time. And Jesus met them. He said, you are sleeping? And then in verse 41, and pray that you enter not into temptation. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh
she's real.
E ma so na ke si ma gbadura ke ko ma ba bo sinu ndewo. Lo na mi fe sugbo se alera fun ara.
And then he went away again the second time and he prayed.
O ri ti pa lo ni ekeji o si gbadura.
43 came and he found them asleep again, their eyes were heavy.
Se keta le ni ogoji. O si won ri tun ba won, won sun ni to oju won ko fowo ni.
People were sleeping.
Awon yin sun.
They were supposed to be busy praying.
Nigba se ko ko won yin lati ma gbadura.
Physically they were sleeping. Ritually they were sleeping. And you know that's what happens. Sleep like that. Open the door to the enemy to come right in. Where does the sleeper? Arise from the dead.
First Thessalonians chapter 5.
From verse 1.
That is
I will speak some of the verses there. Verse 1, but of the times and of the seasons, brethren, you have no need that I write unto you.
Ṣùgbọ́n ní ti àkókò àti ìgbà wọn ni ara èyí kò tún fẹ́ kí akọ ohunkó sí yín.
You yourselves know, brethren, that the day of the Lord so cometh as a thief in the night.
Nítorí pé ìdíkára yín mọ̀ dájúdájú pé ọjọ́ Olúwa ń bọ̀ wá gẹ́gẹ́ bí olè ní
òun. When they shall say peace and safety, then sudden destruction cometh upon them as travail upon a woman with child, and they shall not escape.
Nígbà tí wọ́n bá wí pé àlàáfíà àti àìléwu, nígbà náà ni pààrọ̀ yìí yóò dé sórí wọn gẹ́gẹ́ bí ìrọbí lórí obìnrin tí ó lóyún wọn kì yóò sì sálà.
Because they become careless.
Wọ́n ti di aláfara.
They become sleepy.
Wọ́n ti ń sùn.
They become spiritually drowsy.
Wọ́n rí pẹ́lẹ́ pa tẹ̀mí wọ́n ń tó ògbé.
There is no problem.
Wọ́n ní kò ṣe wu.
There is peace and safety.
Àlàáfíà wà àìléwu ní
ṣe ní tó.
Ẹ jẹ́ kí n sin mi díẹ̀.
That young prophet that was relaxing and evil met him there.
Ó dàbí wòlíì kékeré yẹn níbi tó ti ń sinmi.
Brothers and sisters.
Ẹ̀yà aláàbí lókè ló bẹ̀rẹ̀ sọ fún mi.
The story of that man not have been different if he had not fled.
Ṣé ìsọ̀ ọkùnrin yẹn ìbá bá ti yí àtẹ̀ká ní kò sùn?
He stayed.
Ó dúró mú
un láà.
Ó sì mí.
He was sleeping.
Ó ń sùn.
And the enemy, the agent of Satan, met him there.
Ọ̀tá iníṣẹ́ Sàtáni ó bá ń bẹ̀.
Brought him back to a place where he perished eventually.
Ó sì mú padà wá sí ibì kan náà tó ti ṣègbé.
He started his ministry well, but he finished it in a bad way.
Ó bẹ̀rẹ̀ iṣẹ́ ìránṣẹ́ rẹ̀ ní ọ̀nà tó dára, ṣùgbọ́n ó parí rẹ̀ ní ọ̀nà tó
dára. Ṣùgbọ́n ìpàṣà wí làgbá.
Ẹ̀yà arákùnrin lóbi iṣẹ́ bẹ́ẹ̀ ni ti wá rí.
Àwọn ìṣẹ́ bí wọ́n ṣubí awé.
Ṣé àwọn sì ń gbọ́ sọ̀rọ̀ fún ọ̀tá ta yí?
Wọ́n ń ṣubí ọyọ mí. Wọ́n and the devil is rocking us to sleep, blowing the air of the world upon you and rocking you to sleep. That's four.
That's a kill.
Your brethren are not in darkness, that day shall overtake you as a thief. Ye are all the children of light and the children of the day. We are not of the night nor of darkness.
Where is the counsel
now? The counsel of the Lord and Savior. Let us not sleep as do
others.
Let us not sleep as do
others.
Let us watch and be sober.
Watch.
And be sober. That sleep in the night. And that the drunken are drunken in the night. The day be sober, putting on the breastplate of faith and love, and for an helmet, the hope of salvation.
Ti àwọn bí a ti yẹ ti ọ̀sán kí a máa wà ní àrí kọjá kí a máa gbé ìgbàyà ìgbàgbọ́ àti ìfẹ́ wọ̀ àti ìrètí ìgbàlà fún àṣìwòrì.
If you are expecting the trumpet sound, you need to wake up.
Mo bá retí ìpè láti dún ó yẹ kó tají.
If you are expecting the coming of the Lord, you need to wake up.
Mo bá retí àti bòlúwa tají.
If you are expecting that you will partake in the rapture, you need to wake up.
Mo bá retí pé ó ní ìgbà ó ní panípa nínú ìgbàsókè.
The knowledge of God.
This
is no time to be asleep.
This
is no time to say, I used to run before.
I used
to be zealous before.
I used
to be very, very fiery before. I don't know why I'm like this.
Wake
up yourself. Pinch yourself.
I
said, no, I will not sleep.
So,
I will not allow the devil to rock me to sleep. Disciples of Jesus to sleep. I will wake up. I will be awake. Spiritually. Physically. I will pray. All the disciplines of spiritual life, I will continue there. I will not sleep in the word of God. In watchfulness.
Brother,
sister, wake up.
Put
your feet and call upon the Lord. The Lord is coming. This is not time to sleep.
This is
not time to backslide.
This
is not time to become you. This is not time to become
cursed.
Brother, in the sleep of death, the enemy is against your life.
He
is looking for you. Succeeded with something, will he succeed with you? Succeeded with something, will he succeed with you? Strategy.
Oh yeah, you need to get
that. The devil take you over. My brother. My sister. Jesus says, what I say unto you, I say unto all world.
Now.
The enemy devour your strength. From you.
Grace,
the power, the anointing, the wisdom, the love, the knowledge, everything that he has stolen from you, wake up and get it back. Wake up and get it back. And God Samson eventually got it back.
So
can get it back. Get it back. Everything he has stolen from you. Your closet has become dull. Wake up! Time is no longer there. Wake up! Winning evangelism, passion for souls is no longer there. Wake up! Wake up, brother! Wake up, sister!
Ah.
The Lord is coming. High time to awake.